Dear students, welcome back to Management Entrepreneurship for IT Industries. Myself, Professor Subramanya Bhagwat, your Computer Science Coordinator. I was explaining you about second model. There, I was explaining you about directing. What is directing? Direction, you know, direction is a very, very, very important thing. How fast you are going, not only important, which direction you are going is very important. Suppose, just wait 1 minute, I'll tell you, I'll show you. This side, Mangalore is, you have to go to Mangalore, but you will go this side very, very fast. You won't reach a Mangalore because direction is wrong. So direction is one of the very important thing. What is the direction? Direction is a complex function that includes all those activities which are designed to encourage subordinates to work effectively and efficiently in both the short and long term. You see, yes, we should encourage our team. For example, you are my team. You have to write assignment tomorrow. I am a boss and I am giving you a work. Tomorrow this work has to be done. I should encourage you. Like tomorrow who submits first, I'll give an award or gifts. This one encouragement. Encouragement should be there in for long-term goals also. Because tomorrow if you submit this, if you do this work, 1 lakh rupees tomorrow I won't give. Short-term that work set works, but long-term it doesn't work. So while giving a direction, very clear to watch whatever you are directing, you know, long term it is useful or not. That's a very important thing. Directing, okay, includes issuing orders. I can issue an order, this work has to be done. Or instructing is also called directing. Guiding is also called directing. Helping is nothing but a directing. Motivating, nothing but a directing. Designing a good environment to work, that is nothing but directing. Providing rewards is nothing but directing. Directing includes all these activities like issuing orders, instructions, giving guiding, helping, motivating, designing good environment to work, provide rewards. It's all these things it contains. Next, nature or characteristics of direction. Direction should be dynamic function. Why it is a dynamic function? Anybody can say why it is a dynamic function? Because directing is a dynamic and continuing function. A manager has to continuously direct, guide, motivate and lead his subordinates. Continuous motivation is very important, because any work consistency means today you may work, tomorrow also you should work. Leader should motivate his team to work lifetime. So continuously he should direct, guide, motivate, lead his subordinates. With the change in plans, organizational relationships, he will have to change the methods and techniques to directions. Methods and techniques he should change. It initiates the action. Direction initiates the action. Directing initiates organized and planned actions and ensure effective performance by subordinates toward the accomplishment of group activities. It is regarded as the essential of management in actions. You see here, one person says build a house. Whether next day onwards people will start build a house? No. First he makes a planning. That he gives a direction what to do. Then action. So once direction is there, it initiates action. Once planning is there, they can move according to that plan. They can do that action. In action, they can show that things. They can work. Please try to understand. This direction without action also fails. With action, without direction also fails. So both are very important things. Another important thing, now two important characteristics we studied. Dynamic function, nature of direction is nothing but dynamic functions, because it should be continuous. So because tomorrow some changes happens, like because of corona, we can conduct online classes. We can study continues. learning continuous. Okay, so continuous way we can learn. Even a corona is there also, COVID-19, okay, this offline classes are not available. We can study, we can learn, because online through. So we are changing the strategy. Same way, dynamic function, according to the situations, according to the time, leader should be able to change that thing. So it should continuously, he should be able to assist or direct, as well as he should be able to do that. This is one of the very important, he should be able to achieve achieve the target goal. So very important thing, dynamic function. Direction is dynamic function, initiates actions. It is a universal function. Directing is a universal function that is performed in all organizations and all of the levels of management. All the managers have to guide, motivate, lead, supervise and communicate with their subordinates. Although more time is spent on directing at higher levels of management. So it's a universal function. It provides a necessary link between various management functions. It provides a link. Directing links various managerial functions, planning, organizations, wherever the direction is very important. Planning, organizing, stopping, controlling. Without directing, the functions of controlling will never arise and the other preparatory functions of management will become meaningless. Just now I told, we'll go wrong direction. Even if they go speed, lost to you. So direction is very, very, very important thing. Then it is a concerned with human relationship, one of the very important characteristics. Direction function of management deals with the relationship between people working in an organization. It creates a cooperation, harmony among the members of the group. It seeks to achieve orderly arrangement of group effort to provide unity of action in the unity of action to achieve the objectives. Human relationship maintaining is very important things. Then first question is characteristics. Second question is principles of directing. What are the principles of directing? Harmony of objectives. Coordinate the individual objectives with the organizational objectives. So see here, individually you are happy, you should always be helpful to your organizations. Individually you are not happy, not satisfied. So that no organization's goals you are unable to satisfy. So first thing, principles of directing says harmony of objectives. You should achieve harmony of objectives. Individually everyone should be happy. That is the main important thing. Second one, unity of directions or command. Everybody works towards the goal. That's a very important thing. Everyone, principles of directing says clearly, okay, team leader builds the team direct like that way. Everyone should work according to the achieve their goal, to achieve their directions. Direct supervision. Manager should have direct relationship with their subordinates. Effective communication. Very important thing in principles of directing. Effective communication. Suppose person writes, he wants to say opportunity is nowhere. He writes opportunity is now here. Okay, so he puts comma here. So if things shouldn't happen actually. What happens, you know, what he wanted to say, what is communicated, both are matching or not, that he should identify. Follow throughput. Directing is continuous process. So follow throughput, continuous process it is. So follow up is a very important thing. Then elements of direction. What are the three important elements are there? Motivating, communicating and leading. What is that leading? Let me explain you. Leading means, leading refers to an art of transferring facts, ideas, feelings from one person to another and making him understand them. Leading says, is art of transferring facts, okay, ideas, art of transferring ideas, feelings, etc. from one person to another person. Making him understand them, okay. Manager has to continuously tell his subordinates about what to do. Very, very important thing here, what to do, then how to do and when to do, okay. That is a very, very, very important thing, okay. Always remember that. Once it is clear, what to do is clear, then how to do is clear, when to do is clear, then leading has 100% meaning. So that is a very important thing. Elements of directing is leading. Second one is communicating. What is communicating? Let me tell you. So that concept will be very clear to you. Communicating refers to influence others in a manner to do what the leader wants them to do. Leadership plays an important role in directing. Only throughout this quality, a manager can gain trust and zeal among subordinates. Communication. Suppose you see here, good communication is one of the very important thing. Instead of telling him you do that, you can tell him by doing this what are the benefits you are getting, or you can ask him suggestion. You can motivate him such a way that himself he should agree that I will do it. Yes, I will do it. Next one, okay, motivating. Very, very, very important factor is motivating. Motivating refers to the process which excites people to work, exhorts people to work for attainment of the desired objective. Among the various factors, production, it is only the human factor which is dynamic, provides a mobility to other physical resources. So, while elements of directing, leading, communicating and motivating, very important things. Next one is leadership. What do you understand about leadership? The ability to influence people towards accomplishment of goals. You should be able to influence the people towards the accomplishment of goal. Importance of leadership. Leaders guide, inspire subordinates. Leader will guide. Leader will always, he will guide his subordinates what to do. Leaders build a good work environment. That's a very important thing. Leader build confidence to followers. He should able to do the confidence. He should able to build a confidence in followers. Leader secure a cooperation from the group. Leader act as change agents. Leaders are representatives for the followers. Leaders develop a great vision. Now my question is, one small question I'll ask you. Here is a one team. For this team, animals team, this team, 1,000 dogs, okay, 1,000 dogs and one lion. Lion, okay, here 1,000 lions and one dog. Here in this group, 1,000 dogs, but lion is a leader. Here 1,000 lions, one dog is a leader. Fighting happens. Which will win? Definitely. Okay, 1,000 dogs where one lion is there, this will win 100% compared to 1,000 lions, one dog is there. Because for this group, you know, for second group, 1,000 lions, second group what happened? 1,000 lions, but dog is a leader, that 1,000 lions won't work. So this, okay, they won't win. But these 1,000 dogs, lion is a leader. So all 1,000 dogs act like a lion, they will win. Always leadership is one of the important factors. If leader is correct, everything will be perfect. Then leadership styles. What are the styles of leadership? Autocratic, authoritative style. Or democratic, participative style. Laissez faire, free reign style. What is autocratic leadership? An autocratic leader is one who dominates. Autocratic means who dominates and drives his subordinates through his commands and instilling to fear in his followers. They will obey his order. An autocratic leader alone determines the policies. Autocratic leader alone determines the policies, plans and makes decision. He alone himself will decide. Then he demands strict obedience. He demands strict obedience. Such a leaders love power. They need power and love to use power promoting their own ends. They never like to delegate the power for their fear. They make lose their authority. Autocratic leadership. Then merits also there. It increases efficiency. Suppose some lazy people are working under autocratic leader, they work correctly because this is some benefits are also there in autocratic leadership. Saves time because he always, leader always shouts, autocratic leader always says orders. So everybody will fear, because of fear they complete fast. So it saves a time. quick results under emergency conditions. Emergency conditions, even as leader, any type of leader should become autocratic leader. Then only work will be done fast. Emergency situations. Chain of command and division of work are very clear. Because autocratic leader, okay, always giving a directions, always giving a strict guidelines, he's very strict. So, okay, he shouts, this thing, he gives always order, he doesn't deliver, these things, he doesn't listen. So, communication is one way. And not like this, communication is one way means top to bottom, not bottom to top. Only he gives order. Leader is a leader. His team. Okay, autocratic says leader, this is a leader, this is his team. Leader always gives a direction, they have to obey, they have to do. These are all the benefits of autocratic leadership. Then, okay, some demerits also there. What are the demerits? People are treated machine like machine. So human dignity question arises because he makes insults. So here we are working with people, not with machines. One way to communication without feedback. Feedback he is not taking. Autocratic leader never asks a feedback. He just communicates. The leader receives a little or no inputs from his subordinates for his decision making, which is dangerous. He is not asking anybody and he will directly ask the decisions. So it's very dangerous to current dynamic environment. Next is democratic leadership. What is democratic leadership? This is called participative leadership. What is that participative leadership? Participative leadership, wait. Participative leadership says entire group is involved. Leader is not only involving, leader is not only giving a direction. He is involving whole his team to work. A democratic leader follows the majority opinions as expressed by his group. Always, here communication is two-way. So subordinates have considerable freedom of action. Leader shows greater concerns for his people's interest. Others' happiness is his happiness. Democratic leader is always ready to defend the subordinates individually and collectively. Next one. Merits. What are the merits? Merits. Leadership encourage people to develop and grow. Leadership will always encourage develop and grow. Because what happens? They will be very happy. Our team, if you treat like democratic leadership leader, always okay, democratic leadership says, okay, always, okay, is motivating others to talk. So everybody will be happy, receives information and ideas from his subordinates to make decisions. Boost the morale of employees. It will boost the morale of employees. Demerits. Some leaders may use this style as a way of avoiding. Responsibilities can take what I call enormous amount of time for making decisions because he is asking everyone. Then, okay, merits also clear to you. Merit is nothing but encourages people to develop and grow. It receives information, ideas from his subordinates. Sometimes subordinates' idea may be better than his idea. So it is advantageous. Here, both the way directions, subordinates to boss, boss to subordinates. Then, boosts the morale of employees. Some leaders may use this style as a way of avoiding responsibilities. Demerit is also there. Can take enormous amount of time. Many time, it takes a lot of time because he has to listen all. Pre-reign leadership. Well, leaders exercise absolutely no control. He only provides information, materials and facilities to his subordinates. Leadership is employee-centered. Subordinates are free to establish their own goals, chart out the course of action. Leadership can be disaster if the leader doesn't know well the competence, integrity of his people and their ability to handle this kind of freedom. Suppose without knowing their ability, if you give them freedom, they will make a loss to institution. So pre-reign leadership is very dangerous actually. Autocratic leader-centered methods. Autocratic is nothing but leader-centered method. Democratic is participative method. Pre-reign is employee-centered method. Okay. He says spectrum of leadership styles. Okay. Area of freedom permitted subordinates he has given like this way. Then motivation. What is the motivation? One general example through I tell you. Okay. Suppose, okay, I tell you to run here, okay, this space. Here, okay, I tell you within 1 minute you have to go and you have to run and reach this position. You may not reach, but tiger is attacking you, 100% you will reach within less than, because that is sometimes motivation. I call it as motivation. That's a negative motivation. Positive motivation is like this. For example, if I say that word, if you go and reach within 1 minute that time, okay, I'll give you one gold coin. So you will do that thing. That is because of our gold coin. That's called motivation. Motivation is inspiring the subordinates to contribute with zeal and enthusiasm towards organizational goals. Performance of an employee. How do you measure performance of employee? Ability into willingness. He has having ability, but willingness is not having means zero result, because his formula is ability is there 100% into ability into willingness is performance. Always remember, ability into willingness is performance. Ability 100%, you know that you are capable. Willingness is zero means you won't get result. 100 into 0, 0. Sometimes you don't have ability, but willingness is there. You may not get expected result performance. Sometimes ability is the 20%, willingness is the 100%. That time also, okay, you will get the result, not expected result, result. So ability is also very important, willingness is also important. Motivation and enhancing the willingness to work, which impress the performance. Motivation theories are there. What are the motivation theories? Maslow need hierarchy theory, Hertzberg's two-factor theory, and McCelland achievement theory, Victory Room expectancy theory, Adam's equity theory, Skinner's behavior modification theory. What is that? We'll study. For this, you have to write a diagram. Suppose Maslow's need hierarchy theory. If they ask you, you have to write this diagram, then explain each point. What is physiological needs? Security needs, social needs, esteem needs, self-actualization needs. Please, dear students, please remember, you have to write this diagram. Writing diagram itself carries 80% of the marks. Your explanations nobody will read in this subject, because maximum people, they refer only the key points, diagrams. Everybody can read, but in deep they won't read. If it matches with the headings, they will give you full marks. So you should write perfectly. Heading, you should write perfectly. The subject is like this. Because if you write anything, it's considered as explanation and you can get 2 marks. But 5 out of 5, if you need, you write according to the evaluation scheme. Well, Maslow hierarchy theory. It's one of the very important motivation theory. For this motivation theory, you have to consider these factors. Psychological needs, security needs, social needs, esteem needs, and self-actualization needs. What is psychological needs? The basic needs of sustaining human life itself, such as a food, water, shelter, and sleep. Until these needs are satisfied the reasonable degree necessary to maintain life, other needs will not motivate people. Suppose he is not having a food, if you say that things, if you motivate them, you will give a gold coin. He doesn't expect, or I'll give you an award, Karnataka Ratna Award. They won't agree, because their basic needs should be satisfied. Instead of doing his awards or felicitations, you offer him a food, he will do that work. So he says physiological needs should be maintained perfectly. Until these needs satisfied, they won't work. Then security or safety needs. People want to be free of physical danger, of the fear of losing job, property of shelters. So next, security safety needs very important. Then social needs. Since people are social beings, they need to belong to be accepted by others. Esteem needs. Want people to begin satisfy their needs to belonging, they need tend want to be held in esteem both by themselves and by others. This kind of needs, such satisfactions, power, prestige, status. All this comes esteem needs, power. Suppose he is not working, some person is not working. Instead of motivating him, if you give him 2,000, he is also not working. But if you make him a promotion, only designation manager. So, for example, sales person, sales agent, we promote him sales manager, he works. The same way, Because this esteem needs, self-actualization needs. It is desire to become what one capable of becoming, maximum one's potential and accomplishing something. Okay. Next one. Yeah. Hertzberg's two-factor theory. What is that Hertzberg two-factor theory? We will study in, next class.